Our next speaker is Lindy Antonides. Did I say that right, Lindy? Okay, very good. She said, say it phonetically. It's like, I don't know how to spell it. But she has lived a full life, including an extended time in Hawaii, a location Lindy absolutely loves. She loves the food and the people, and she's a bit of a risk taker, taking risks in Hawaii and aside from being in Hawaii. Some would say that she's a live wire, and maybe we'll hear one of those stories tonight. Welcome, Lindy.
Yeah, I kind of shifted from at-home mom of four to, I don't know, in the bliss. But anyway, your stories were amazing. I'm going to talk tonight a little bit about happenstance. I happened to find the word the other day, and it means things that just happen. So I found myself, probably 15 years ago, switching, sold everything I owned, went to Hawaii, ended up on the streets, lived on the streets for 2 years. And one day, after 10 years, and I never paid rent the whole time I was there. Of course, we homeless people don't pay rent. But anyway, I lived on the beaches, beautiful places, met some awesome people. And when in that shift, I learned how to get my food. I learned how to take a shower out of a bag. You know, I learned a lot of different things, but the main thing I learned was that every single person that comes in my path has a purpose. Every single one of those people. I can remember the day I was going to go home because I had now a grandchild. And so I thought, okay, open this door because I have no money. I had a car though. I finally got a car. When my mother died, she left me a little money and I got a car, and I was living in that part of the time. So I took my money and I got a ticket, and I was just standing there thinking, what am I going to do? I sold everything. I don't have anything to go back to. And I got this call because I had a cell phone, and this friend of mine called and he says, my wife and I were talking, and my daughter's going to college, and we don't want to be in our house alone, and we were just thinking about you. And I just started bawling because I thought, okay, here's my little open door. Well, now I've learned to watch for the open doors. 10 years forward, my daughter is now living in Hawaii, and she's going to graduate as a chief warrant officer of weapons. So I want to go, but I still have no money. And so I'm swimming at this pool, a senior center, and this lady says, well, I think that could happen. So Sunday, I go to a church I haven't even been to in ages, and I'm in there, and I thought, I guess I'll put my last 10 bucks in the offering just because I want to do it. And this girl comes following me out, and she goes, hey, you're supposed to be in Hawaii. You're not supposed to be here. I said, oh, yeah? And she hands me some money, and I thought, she says, get online because the tickets are really cheap. And the mandates had just lifted. So, yeah, the tickets were pretty good. You couldn't get in Hawaii before with the mandates. So this is just last year, and it was my 70th birthday. So I thought, oh, I really want to go. I get home. She had handed me $500. So I get online, I got a ticket for $650, and then I started to panic because I just do these things. And I thought, what am I gonna do? You know, I mean, I don't have any place to stay and I don't have money to go there, but I thought, well, I've lived down the streets, I can check in a hostel or do something. Every time I had that thought for the next 2 months, somebody handed me a $100 bill. And this is true. And by the time it was time to go, I had $1,200. But I still didn't really want to do, like when I go every year because since I've lived there, and I just go on a whim and I take a backpack, I wear a bathing suit, a dress, and a pair of pants, sometimes shoes. That's all I bring. don't have anything. I usually don't go with money, but this time I went with money. So I get there and I called one of my friends from the paddling club and I says, hey, can you pick me up? And he says, oh yeah, I'll be your Uber driver again. So he comes, he picks me up, he's driving me all over the island. He said, where are you gonna stay? And I said, I don't know yet. I think Rhonda has a place to stay. So my friend Rhonda, who owns a sprout farm, and she calls me, she says, yeah, you can stay here. So I stayed there. And it was just like I ran into people. One of them, her name was Hope. One of them, her name was Blessing. And I just think, I find it kind of ironic that people's names kind of go with what's happening in my moment. And so anyway, I ended up staying. I went for the month of April. And while I was there, I did a little property management when I lived there. And this guy calls me from the Holly Eva North Shore. He says, I'm a chief here, and I heard about you. Are you on the island? And I said, well, I'm going home. And he said, well, I'll pay you $5,000 to stay here. And I thought, yeah, this property's got to be a piece of shit. And probably 20 people living on it, you know, or whatever. I get up the mountain on Pupakea Mountain, and it's a $12 million property, and you can drive my Mercedes. And I'm just going, you know, I remember the days when I first came home, and I had to fill out for the DHS, because I'm now very low income. All these forms and numbers, and my numbers were all zero. I had sold everything. I don't have property, I don't have a pension, I don't have anything. Savings, checking, nothing. And at the end, I signed it, and this thought came to me, zeros are your friends. And I thought, yeah, happy me. And so when I got to Hawaii, the same voice said to me, zeros are your friends with numbers in front of them. And this guy calls me. So anyway, I love life. I think it's awesome. Thank you for having me here. She's a happenspance person in my life. I just happened to meet her visiting my sister. So thank you for this opportunity. I love life.